The treasures, the gold, the relics has been reclaimed and how much of it remains. Now, say it's 50% has been recovered. That means some of the most incredible works of art, some of the most incredible hoards of gold and silver, and some of the arguably potentially greatest relics of antiquity are lying there in a cave somewhere, sitting in a no longer used rail station, or high up in a mountain somewhere. I think over time, we'll find some of this, but just how much is there and what's there, that remains a mystery.
The Nazi legacy can be seen in the scars on the landscape, the graveyards scattered in every city, town, and village across the world, and in the voids of art galleries, where once hung the greatest paintings in history. The theft of art was a cultural crime the likes the world had never seen. But hopefully, more will be recovered so that future generations can enjoy them once again.
No.
Who's launching secret space shots from Oklahoma?
Is this a rocket that was launched without anybody knowing? It's exploding.
Sightseers enjoy pristine beaches, lush rainforests, and breathtaking sunsets. October 21st, 1993, a man films on a cliff edge as the earth begins to crumble. The landslide is followed by a huge torrent of water.
People should be terrified.
The man with the camera continues to film while elemental forces smash the landscape around him.
Whatever this is, it's massive. And this guy looks like he's in serious danger.
Standing there witnessing that must have felt like watching the earth cracking.
The footage is time-stamped October 21st, 1993. But despite the epic destruction in this incredible footage, there is no official written report on the event to explain what happened. Explorer George Karunas wonders if this mysterious footage could be of an event unseen since prehistoric times.
One thing that happened in the Mediterranean was that the sea flooded into what is now known as the Black Sea.
The area occupied today by the Black Sea was once fertile land, inhabited by Stone Age farmers, with a small freshwater lake in the middle. That all ended around 5000 BC, with one of the most destructive events ever witnessed by man. We've seen tsunamis in our own time, 5 million years ago, what we call the Zantian flood, and this is when the Atlantic Ocean burst through the Straits of Gibraltar and flooded into the Mediterranean. Scientists believe that this huge volume of water cascaded down about half a mile with 1,000 times the force of the Amazon River. It effectively separated Europe from North Africa forever. Science journalist John Farrow wonders if the footage might have captured a similar type of event.
Looking at all this water rushing in, it's almost biblical. It's like the Great Flood.
Planetary scientist Cyan Proctor searches for evidence to support Farrow's Great Flood theory.
This could be a mass flood that we're seeing, but I don't think it is. The records show that there was no flooding happening in the region at that time. So something else must be happening here.
Earth scientist Alan Shapiro joins the investigation. He examines the footage, and his focus is drawn to the contouring of the wall of Earth moments before it collapses.
You can see this stepping pattern, which looks like an open-pit mining operation.
Mining is one of the main industries in Malaysia, and much of this is large-scale open-pit mining.
One of Malaysia's major exports is tin, and there are tin mines across the landscape. But how do we go from a tin mine to a massive landslide and flood?
Open cast mining operations often include a dam to keep river water from entering the excavated pit. Dam failures often lead to mining tragedies. On November 5th, 2015, a dam at an iron mine in Brazil catastrophically failed, unleashing over 52 million cubic yards of water, mud, and iron ore sludge. It was Brazil's worst ever environmental disaster.
With
the torrent annihilating 375 homes and killing 19 people. But the sheer amount of liquid in this footage is way beyond any normal dammed up river. Karuna sees a clue in the color of the water that lies beyond the mine's earth wall.
Looking at the horizon on the video, you can see the ocean. What were they thinking? Building an open pit mine so close to the ocean. How do you not see this coming?
As mine failures go, this has got to be the most epic ever caught on camera.
Details of this mine failure remain shrouded in mystery. Aside from this incredible footage, there is no known written record of this titanic flood event. It is still not known if anyone was injured or killed. The only other evidence is a half-mile-wide cove where the mine used to be, a testament to the incredible force of water.
We dug out this great big pit next to the ocean, and guess what? Mother Nature is taking it back.
Now, a crack of light splinters the night sky.
Chances are whatever it's doing is not good.
Is someone launching an illegal rocket on American soil?
If I was living in the area, I want to know if it's dangerous.
Or is a new weapon being unleashed?
If you were on the ground, near where this was taking place, you'd be dead in an instant.
Nuclear test in the American West. This underground test chamber was topped by a manhole cover. They blew up a nuclear